Nina West, you, my dear, are the pride of season 11. Now, sashay away.
If you had to describe your Drag Race experience in just a few words, how would you sum it up?
So the important thing is, right, when you're probably sitting at home, if you're sitting at home and you're watching this and you're a drag queen, you're like, I could do that. I will tell you, you're going to say that to yourself a million times, and then when you do it, you're going to say, it's the most challenging thing I've ever done. It's the most humbling experience I've ever had, but it's been the most rewarding. And so I think that's any good sign of an incredible, incredible career experience like this. I can't even imagine that I'd ever thought this would happen to me.
And here you are.
And here I am.
On ET.
Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-
break the heel.
It's a lot of weight. It's a lot of weight on these babies. I hope that people are able to walk away and say, there's a queen who loves her art form, loves her craft, uses it for the betterment of her community, who is taking every opportunity to lift up all of us and not just herself. I am a drag queen who, I'm from Columbus, Ohio, and I've done this for 18 years, and I have my own charitable foundation. I've raised over $2.5 million for local organizations in my community, and that has been the benchmark of my career and the proudest part of my career, and to have this platform to hopefully explode that and take it to another level would be a dream, and I just want people to connect to me, like my authentic self and who I am and what I represent and the good that I can hopefully do for all of us.
Did you surprise yourself?
Oh my gosh, yeah. You're doing something that is so insanely personal and so insanely emotional, right? In so many different ways. It's the most challenging thing I've ever done in my life. So when you're like distilled, right? That's how the best way I can think of it. You're distilled down to the sum of your parts, right? Like what makes you mm-hmm. out of drag. And then you have to put on this incredible mask and persona that is, for the most part, intrinsically still yourself, overly personified.
Right.
You have to deal with the things you find out about yourself along the journey, and that can be tough. And you're doing it in the confines of a reality TV show, right? And you're doing it in the confines of a competition for $100,000
right.
with RuPaul watching and all these special guests watching. So you have to, like, there's a lot to juggle, and there's a lot to maintain and try to figure out how to navigate and negotiate in your emotions. So I surprised myself. I also scared myself. I also was like, oh, I didn't know I knew that about me, or I didn't know I felt that way, or this whole thing is a journey.
Yeah.
And that's why Drag Race is such a pop culture phenomenon, because people are at home watching and they're like, oh my God. And they're empathetic and they're going on the journey with us and they're feeling things and they're learning things about themselves. It's incredible.
Yeah.
It's a gift of a television show, I think.
There's people under these wings.
Yeah, yeah. And these tits are here. They're here and they're, no, but right, we're people, and you see the glitz and the glamour that's really like overly pronounced, but underneath all of this were these guys who have these incredible feelings, and then we grow to have these immense bonds with one another, and in turn, it changes our art and our drag forever.
What does that mean now to be interviewed by Entertainment Tonight, that you grew up?
Oh my God, right. So like, I'm a kid of the late 80s, and so I remember sitting down at like 7:30 at night, and watching Entertainment Tonight, catching up on my entertainment gossip, finding out about my favorite actors, and it was through Entertainment Tonight. And it was how I knew what celebrities had birthdays. And it was like, you know, right? It was, and Mary Hart was a staple. And John Tesh, right? I mean, come on. So to be here, it's crazy. I've always dreamt that this would happen, and I never knew it would happen, right? I'm like, oh my God, to be on Entertainment Tonight. And here I am. I mean, it's crazy. It's nuts. Like, it's this weird full circle moment of like being a little kid and now here.